today, which is a great celebration for us, because we finished the 40 days of the fast. And as our bishop said to us last week, that was the sort of the main story, and now we have the sequel coming up. The sequel begins with great joy, not with the derision that comes later in the week and the pain and suffering, but great joy. Even though there is a little bit of that suffering with Lazarus' death, is to the glory of God. His first lines initially, that this sickness is not unto death, but that God might be glorified, can be really a model for all of our lives. All the difficulties each of us has, whether it's family difficulties or illnesses or diseases or temptations or passions or poverty, whatever they may be, they can't be to the glory of God. They don't have to be unto our own spiritual death or physical death, ultimately. We have to take the things we've been given, the trials that we have, and fill them up with Christ, with the presence of Christ. As Mary and Martha saw fit to do the right thing, to go call Christ into the most difficult of situations, that Lazarus might be healed. And of course, the Lord in his abundant wisdom waited to come until time is right. Time is right when Lazarus had already died a physical death. Of course, the people fear bringing him out of the tomb. This is impossible. You hear the doubts that they have. Couldn't this man who had healed the blind and made people walk, and couldn't he possibly have kept Lazarus from dying? Jesus shows forth, of course, his humanity and his divinity in this passage by his both of his natures in one person by weeping. Presence of Lazarus, because death is not natural, despite what we tell each other now. It is not natural. It's absolutely unnatural, opposed to the order of things that God intended. But him being God, called forth Lazarus from the tomb, as he calls us forth. He says to each and every one of us, come forth. Come forth from the sicknesses that you have. Come forth from the spiritual death. Come forth from the stony hearts that you have created for yourselves by your sins. Come forth to me, to follow me, as Lazarus would soon do. Of course, end up being the Bishop of Cyprus eventually. Having to die again, Lazarus did die twice, something that most of us will never experience, except for our deacon, of course. He did die twice, in some ways. And God willing, to resist that. We have to follow this. This is our hope. Confirm the universal resurrection, as he says today. He's confirmed the universal resurrection. So with that despair coming forth in the future weeks, as the Lord did with his transfiguration, when he proclaimed his passion around that event, he showed the people that despite as bad and dark as things may seem to be, there is hope. He's going to call us forth from the tombs as well. He's going to be transfigured despite that happening. I heard Bishop Callistos one time telling of a mosaic, I don't remember the time where it was, but it was supposed to be a mosaic of the Transfiguration. It wouldn't hit you at first because it was up on a hill and there was a big cross with light coming forth from it. And the point was that before resurrection comes the passion, comes crucifixion. Before our spiritual resurrection comes forth temptations and trials and difficulties. That's how we are transfigured. This is how Lazarus, of course, is ultimately transfigured. And this day should bring us forth great joy, and you see the people laid to the streets with the palms of victory, as we will talk about tomorrow, because they've seen this and they are amazed. But alas, they still didn't get it. They still thought that this was just some worldly king coming to bring some kind of worldly power, as the bishop talked about with James and John. It's the same thing. They didn't quite get it. But Jesus comes in humility. Jesus comes crucified. Jesus comes in extreme humility of the bridegroom icon we will see. He comes forth and shows us that we can only be glorified if we debase ourselves. If we are abased, we'll be exalted. The more humble we become, the more Christ-like we become. As Lazarus became more Christ-like through his death, and Christ showed forth his power through the most extreme weaknesses, through his death, through his waiting, the people thinking that he couldn't do anything, and ultimately through his own death, he rose up himself. promises us resurrection in this Lazarus. So we remember this example of Lazarus today and all the difficulties of our lives. Things seem so grim, how grim things may ever seem to be for us. But Christ too calls us to come forth ultimately to his resurrection. Amen.
Amen.